Question number 3, statement problems. Okay, so question number 3, let's read the question. Raju brought a book for rupees 35.65. He gave rupees 50 to the shopkeeper. How much money did he get back from the shopkeeper? Okay, so Raju is buying a book. Okay, what is the cost of the book? 35 rupees and 65 paise. Okay, 35.65. He is giving 50 rupees to the shopkeeper. Okay, so how much money the shopkeeper must give him back? That is the question. Okay, so how much money he will get back from the shopkeeper? So what we have to do, we have to subtract here. Okay, so look into the solution. Cost of the book is 35.65 and money paid by him to the shopkeeper is how much? 50 rupees. Okay, so now money got back by him. Okay, how much he is getting back? So he has to subtract. Okay, so 50 minus 35.65. Clear? Now we have to subtract 50 and 35.65. Okay, so subtracting them, 50. So 50. Okay. And 35.65. So 35.65. Okay, now for 50, can I keep a decimal and add two zeros? Yes, then only we can subtract. No, there is no numbers. So I am placing a decimal and I am adding two zeros. Now we can subtract. Okay, so you are 0 and 5, you can't subtract. So go to the before number, there also 0. Okay, so we can't regroup. Then again, next digit is also 0. Okay, so we can't regroup. Now go to 5. Okay, so regrouping from 5. So 5 becomes 4. Okay, now what happens to this 0? This 0, okay, this will become 9. Okay, and this 0 will become 9. And this 0 will become 10. Now 10 minus 5 will be 5. 9 minus 6 is 3. Again 9 minus 5 is 4. And 4 minus 3 is 1. Okay. And decimal point is before two numbers. So place it before two numbers. Okay. So what is the amount or what is the money the shopkeeper must give him back? It is rupees 14.35. Okay. Is it clear? So 14.35 should be given back to him by the shopkeeper. Clear, children? Rani had rupees 18.50. She bought one ice cream for rupees 11.75. How much money does she have now? Okay, so at the beginning, Rani had rupees 18.50. Okay, she was having 18.50. From that 18.50, from that money, she is buying a ice cream. Okay, and the cost of the ice cream was 11.75. Okay, now after buying the ice cream, how much money is remaining with her? Okay, so what we have to do? We have to subtract. Okay, how much money does she have now? After buying ice cream, how much money she is having now? We can find out by subtracting. Okay, now subtracting 18.50, okay, and minus 11.75. okay, subtracting them, what do we get? 18.50 and 11.75. okay, now subtracting 0 and 5, so regroup. This becomes 4, this becomes 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. Okay, and this becomes 7, it's 14. So 14 minus 7 is 7, and 7 minus 1 is 6. Okay, so 1 minus 1 is 0. Now 6, where should I place a decimal point? Before two numbers. So 6.75 is the money. Question number 5. Tina had 20 meter 5 centimeter long cloth. She cuts 4 meter 50 centimeter length of cloth from this for making a curtain. How much cloth is left with her? Okay, so totally she is having 20 meter 5 centimeter cloth. Okay, from that She is cutting. Okay, 4 meter 5 centimeter length. She is cutting from the total cloth. Okay, to make a curtain. Now, after cutting down, how much cloth is left with her? We have to find. Okay, so we have to subtract here from the total. We have to subtract the length of the cloth for making curtain. Okay, if we subtract both, we will get the remaining cloth left with her. Clear, children? Solution 5th one. Okay, so the total length of the cloth, Tina, the total length of the cloth she had is 20 meter 5 centimeter. Okay, and the length of the cloth used for curtain. Okay, from this 20 meter 5 centimeter, 4 meter 50 centimeter cloth is used for curtain. Okay, so we have to find the length of cloth left, or the remaining length of cloth left. Okay, so we have to subtract them. Okay, so here you can see 2 units. Since it is length, it is in meter and centimeter. Okay, so length of the cloth, so the unit here is meter and centimeter. Okay, now we have to subtract them. Before subtracting, I have to convert this centimeter also to meter. Okay, so 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So what is 1 centimeter? 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meter. Yes, so 5 centimeter will be equal to 5 divided by 100. Okay, so as I told you, denominator there are 2 zeros, numerator we have 1 number, so we have to place a decimal point before 2 numbers by adding 0 here. Okay, so we have 0.05 meter. Clear? Same way in this we have 50 centimeter. That 50 centimeter also we have to convert to meter. Okay, so 50 centimeter will be equal to 50 divided by 100. Okay, so 50 divided by 100, so denominator 2 zeros. Okay, so place a decimal before 2 numbers, 0.50 meter. Clear, children? Now we have converted both centimeters to meter. Okay, now here 20 meter, okay, centimeter converted to meter is plus 0.05 meter. Okay, we have to add both, no? Okay, minus 4 meter, 50 centimeter is 0.50 meter. Okay, first we have to add these two. Same way we have to add these two. Okay, then we have to subtract them. Okay, so here 20 meter plus 0.05 meter. Can we write it as 20.05 meter? Yes. So 20.05 meter minus 4 meter and 0.50. Okay. So 4 meter. 4 is a whole number. Here in the ones place you have 4. Okay. So can we write it as 4.50 meter? Yes. Now we have to subtract them. Okay. So 20.05. Okay, and 4.50. Where should we put that 4? That 4 is in 1's place. So, in 1's place, we have to put the decimal point should be on the same vertical line. So, 4.50. Okay, now we have to subtract them. Okay, so 5 minus 0. 5 minus 0 is 5. Okay, now you have 0 and 5 here. You can't subtract. So, you have to regroup. So before number is also 0. Okay, so from this also we can't subtract. Okay, so we have to regroup from this 2. Okay, so this 2 will become 1. Okay, this 0 will become 9 and this 0 will become 10. Okay, now 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 minus 4 is also 5. Okay, so decimal point, we have to, here you have a 1. Okay, so that 1 also you have to bring down. Now, you have to place a decimal point before 2 numbers. Okay, so 15.05 5 5, and what is the unit? It is meter. Okay, so the length of cloth left is 15.55 meter. Clear, children?